live?
We are live.
Hi. Hello, people. Welcome to another fun episode of What's Up With Dead by Daylight this week. Thank you for joining me. Specifically this week, we have our friend Gabriel somewhere on vacation, probably resting or something. Hopefully she's not watching this.
She's in the chat.
Oh, shit. You should be resting. I hope you're at least in your pajamas. That's all I'm going to say about that. Then again, who am I to tell you what to do? All right. Let me just get, the chat back. There we are. And Discord. So I have my trusted crew with me. Wonderful. Okay. So today, thank you, Bjorn, for joining us and making this smooth as possible, hopefully. There's a... there seems to be a... It doesn't matter. Okay. And we have a shit ton of mods with us today. So can you pop it up so we can say hi? We
awesome.
Have... I can see Bucket Red there. I can see Sujan is here. Obviously...
there we go.
Sassy, Isayu, Clyde, Ludzi, Murph, Ryuti, Sassy, Shiroku... Suggestive and Vorfidus.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome all to this fun little corner of the internet. So today we're going to talk about a few things, and at the end we're going to go into a little details about what's happening with Mr. Bing Bong.
Ooh, that's exciting.
Yes. So for a start, the Letterface update that we did on Thursday was rather small, as some of you may have noticed.
Sure.
The main reason for that, there were no big game-breaking bugs, which is usually what gets fixed really quickly after. And there was small little elements of balancing, but that's probably gonna come later when we've had more time to see how people play. For now, he seems to be very popular. People like playing with Leatherface.
Absolutely.
And people are not screaming too hard about playing against him, so we assume that things are smooth.
It seems like it's going both ways. It's good.
Yeah, that's kind of the point, usually. New York Comic Con next week. So, Gabriel, myself, you, and Paul will be packing our bags. Pack lightly, by the way. Yeah, we're not checking baggage.
Okay, that's fair enough.
And we're heading out to New York to go to Comic Con. So it's going to be madness for a few days there. It should be fun. We're going to talk to people. We have a few things to bring. If you have your Dead by Daylight cosplay, wear it and come see us. We will be mad with joy, and we might reward you with some very, very cool swag.
Goodies?
Yep. We might have goodies to give people. So that's Comic-Con. After that, the next thing we're going to do is, I believe, Gabriel and I will be heading out to Long Beach to go to TwitchCon.
Awesome.
That's end of October.
That's been cool.
And after that, I'll be at WePlay in Shanghai at the end of the month.
Awesome.
If you are near Shanghai, or you just feel like spending your air miles on a plane ticket, come see me at the WePlay.
Yeah.
I'll be giving out a talk about Dead by Daylight. Because I can't talk about anything else. Literally, I can't.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's unfortunate.
Well, you know, I tried.
Not even small talk? But the weather.
There's rain now in Mother's Dwelling.
There is. That's,
that's still only Dead by Daylight. Okay, big update, important stuff. Loss of progress, which is the biggest issue plaguing us right now.
Yeah.
There is progress. We have something that we think might fix it, but since it's such a dangerous place to go and fiddle, right now we've put that in the hands of a few specific people that are testing a new way to save the game. And it's the kind of weird issue that's always a bitch to test, because what we need to test is to make sure it doesn't happen again.
Yeah.
So giving it to 10, 50, 100 people and waiting a week, a month, and going, yep, it still hasn't happened, is still not proof that it will never happen again. So
pretty much.
We reach a certain level of certainty at some point, and we'll push it out to everyone.
Is there any possibility of giving this to people that ask for it?
Yes. So the next step for this, right now we just poked a few people specifically
and
said, flip the switch on and see. So we're gonna have that for a few more days. When we have a reasonable level of confidence in this, we are gonna probably open it up to the public through our regular channels, whether it's Steam and Reddit and Discord channels, and we'll ask people, if you wanna participate in testing this, here are the steps to make sure you have a backup of your save, and here are the steps to try the new save feature, and then if anything happens, let us know.
That's
the plan so far.
Cool.
Then the other thing, the big one right now, is there's a hook that you can get stuck in. It's a stupid, stupid bug.
I really don't like that bug.
No. We have a fix internally. We are testing it right now, so it's not going to be pushed immediately. We need to test it, but we have a fix, so it's going to happen very quickly. There. Console news. Leatherface is out on Xbox One since, I think, Tuesday. I might be confused, but yeah, since this week, Leatherface is available on Xbox. PS4 will get it on Tuesday next week, so that's the 3rd of October. Leatherface on PS4. The side effect of this, which is really cool, is that the Xbox and PS4, when they get Leatherface, will also be up to date with the patches and bug fixes and balancing changes and everything else that goes with that patch.
Cool.
That's really cool. DBD VR when?
That's a good question.
We tested a few things at the very, very beginning of the project. I don't know if you were on the project at the time. Yeah. We plugged in an Oculus Rift and we just sort of shoved it in and we could try, and it was extremely nauseating because it wasn't made for it, but it was fun.
I can imagine how much stress that would
The be killer fun. In that vision is sort of okay, but it's kind of difficult to live with. And the survivor, it's just so stressful. Like, you're so in there that it's almost unplayable. You can't play more than a game. Like, you're just like, okay, that's enough. I need a rest now.
Well, I'm excited to try it.
But we never really pushed that in any significant way. We did. We always keep that sort of in the back burner. Even the room that we're in right now, you can't tell because it's invisible. Because it's a green room, but the reason it's green and it's like this is because this is our VR room here in the studio. So true. When we're not streaming from this room, we are testing VR stuff for whatever project. You can't show the green walls; it just won't show because green is invisible. Everybody knows that. So we do have VR in mind regularly, and if we can do something with VR, we will. It'd be really cool. Will endgame chat be added to PS4? Most likely not.
Don't know if chat's in a good place right now, in general.
Yeah.
Well, people are a little salty.
Yeah.
I do see they send messages anyways, so I mean...
There are ways to communicate, it's kind of an incentive for us not to fiddle with that. There's ways to communicate.
But I think we should fix chat in general and work to add it elsewhere. Maybe a better way to do it.
Was Leatherface meant to come with a survivor? No, Leatherface was always meant to come as a standalone killer. That was kind of the goal. Also, for us, it was a test. We were wondering if players would respond well to an update, pardon me, which is just a killer. Mm. Obviously, you have spoken loudly that it's absolutely something that you value. So it might happen again. Standalone survivor or standalone killers is now something that we are considering. Are you still trying to show the green screen?
We're green, yo.
Is that working? Ah, there. So this is what the room actually looks like.
It's true.
So slightly exciting. Okay. That's the news. Oh yeah, okay, so right now we're working on a patch that very likely will come right after the stream.
Awesome.
I want to go into a little bit of details about what is going to get patched today. It's going to be very interesting. Can we get some type of profanity filter to block out certain words, specifically racial comments and all forms of slurs? It's very, very difficult to get that in, especially because people are kind of clever about bypassing that anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a button that allows you to just close the whole chat, and if you feel like you're not getting anything from it.
We might make possibility of making
put a
it
filter.
So you can, you know, disable
yeah.
the actual chat by default as well. I don't know if it's necessary for everybody, perhaps. You know?
Yeah.
Not for everyone. Which is okay, too.
Yeah. But, I mean, don't be a dick. Please. Anyway. I know it's not sufficient. We also have to take measures to help people create a better environment. But
of course.
Really. Okay, patch today. Let's talk about what's gonna happen. So there's this. I'm ashamed, but so last patch in the patch notes it said reduce the audio levels of the raid growls while cloaked.
Mm-hmm. We never said by whose perspective,
which is completely
start with.
Completely dumb. That's a beautiful miscommunication
yes,
on our part and on
yeah,
on
yeah,
our
yeah,
our
yeah, yeah.
way of talking about it. So yes, in this patch. The survivors will also hear the audio levels lowered when the raid growls. Because
yes,
the previous patch only had it for the growler.
Mm-hmm. Please let us know if this is much better. I'm assuming.
Today's patch is not called the Letterface Cube. That's
no,
not
sir.
What it was.
What
okay.
would you call it today?
Just a patch. I think it's 1.7.1b or something. I don't
That's
know.
True.
It gets very confusing. Adjusted the perk open-handed to be effective versus the perk knockout.
Yeah.
That
so
is
now you
really,
can
really cool.
Use open-handed to extend the range by an extra 4, 6, 8 meters, I believe.
But why did you say that, McLean? You know that if you write stuff, I say it. It's like Ron Burgundy. That don't do that. Okay.
Now he's going to do it. Well, he asked for
so,
it.
Open-handed now is going to be effective versus knockout, which is great. Change the barbecue and chili perk to give the bonus blood point post-game rather than during the game, which is a big change. The other change also is that it actually gives a 25% token.
Almost. It's 15, 20, 25% between the three levels.
Yeah. Okay.
Per unique survivor who are hooked.
For the first time.
For the first time. In there. A match. So you can get a total of 15 times 4, 20 times 4. Yeah. So enjoy that. 60, 80, and 100% are the total maximum blood points you can get post-match.
If you put everybody on
yes.
the thing.
Once
good.
Each. Once each. Be good.
Then adjusted the perk Franklin's Demise to be ineffective when killers use their power. So the chainsaw will not trigger that anymore.
Yeah. Shelby asked me to reword that. It's supposed to mean that your main attack, your main weapon, if it hits the survivor, it will cause
then
the item
drop.
To drop. If you're using a chainsaw, for example, it will not cause the item to drop. This is to create a an active decision-making process for you as a player to think, this guy has a flashlight, maybe I'm not going to take the double damage on him and go for the hit to force the flashlight drop.
There are no other powers that would trigger that.
What do you mean by powers?
Well, that's it. So it's only the main attack. That's how we're rewording it. Because right now it was the chainsaw, but there was no, like, if you
but
step
if you
in a
use,
bear trap, you wouldn't drop it.
No, but if you use the nurse and you blink and you do a blink attack.
Then it's still your main attack.
It's still your main attack.
There
as
you
long
go.
As that's clear.
Adjusted bloodlust to not affect the cannibal's chainsaw rev speed. That was a little much. So yes, there are tweaks to Leatherface.
Yeah.
But yeah. This was just an adjustment. Adjusted the cannibal speed limiter add-on to allow multiple hits with the chainsaw on contact.
Absolutely. So now you can actually use his power to multiple hit people. I believe it hits with every second you can create damage, and we might make it less or more depending on how powerful it is. This should, in theory, work against Borrow Time as well.
Good.
Yeah. Have fun.
Change the number of reduced hatchets from 2 to 4 with the iridescent head add-on for the Huntress.
It's true. Now you can only use one hatchet with the head for the Huntress. So double damage, only one hatchet. You're going to be forced to use an add-on. Now, I don't think this is the end of the updates for this add-on. Just for the time being, this is a better decision, we believe. But eventually, it might even be possible to put the borrowed time effect, not the visual effect, but like, or maybe the visual effect. But when you hit somebody with this advanced hatchet, it would put them in a bleed out.
So they wouldn't fall immediately.
Exactly.
Okay.
Which could be a nice way to balance it. So
maybe.
We're looking into this.
And then there's a few bug fixes specifically.
Mm-hmm.
So fix the decisive strike skill checks in tiers 1 and 2 appearing at the wrong percentage of the wiggle bar for the non-obsession.
I think
very
it was
specific,
like
but that was very, very
50.
Annoying.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Fixed an issue that caused the audio to become corrupted after dropping a firecracker in front of a cannibal.
Apparently it blocks Huntress hatchets as well. So we're looking
That's a tough skill one to do. You can drop a firecracker and that blocks the...
Yeah.
If you still have them.
Yeah, if you still have them. So, Jesus.
Fixed an issue that caused players to be launched in the air when vaulting over a pallet as it was being destroyed with a chainsaw, which we pleasantly called here the Hillbilly Space Program.
Yes.
That's fixed.
He keeps returning.
Yeah. The whole sequence of interaction of going over a pallet leads to a lot of weird states.
Getting locked into an interaction.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But this one should be fixed. Fixed an issue that caused players queued for a public lobby to join a private lobby after the host unchecked the friends only option in match management. So in Kill Your Friends, if you remove the friends only option, it should mean that people can click on you and join you even though they're not friends, or you can invite them even if they're not friends. But now it just opened you up to a public lobby state, which was not the
intent.
No. Fixed an issue that could cause the shape to have no head after the prestige reward. So
wonderful.
I'm sure people are going to cherish now their pictures of a headless Michael Myers.
How does a man stalk you with no face?
It's
Myers.
There you go.
Beautiful.
So that's not going to happen anymore. Good. So that's the news, and that's the patch that's coming right now.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, let's talk about Mr. Bing Bong.
Mr. Bing Bong. All right, so as you may know, the Hag is the next... No, I'm just kidding. The Wraith is the next cube
that's
coming up. Is it fun?
Yeah, it's a little funny.
We've looked into a few things for our friend Mr. Bing Bong. You are getting he's getting the silent treatment, which is good for him because it's basically making him quieter when he's walking near people. We're also looking into a few other nice quality of life buffs. Currently, his cloak speed, we think, is a little too long. So we're going to be reducing it to 1 second so that he can actively use this in chases. This could be quite an interesting change, as he took long before and gave himself away quite easily. His cloak speed would slow him down in terms of movement pretty much 50% of his speed, his maximum speed, which meant that he would slow down a ton, as well as give you a 3 second, hey, I'm here. Do something, which is too much time for a lot of people, and the Wraith didn't really capitalize on those situations. That change, we're going to basically make it so that it still takes 3 seconds to uncloak. You can change this with add-ons, but you'll be moving at the same speed as survivors. What this should imply is that a Wraith who's decloaking beside you will be very dangerous, and you should be using your pallets, your windows, to try to create a distance between him before he's able to interact with you. Wraiths, please use this ability to not decloak to force a window jump or a pallet drop. Could be in your benefit. Do you have a question?
No. I'm not looking at questions happening right now.
In addition to these changes, the bell sound, so when he rings his bell, is going to be at 24 meters. It used to be infinite across the map. The add-ons that did affect this, reducing the range by 15 and 30%, will now no longer affect the bell sound. The bell sound will be static to 24 meters. For those of you following, if you like monitored and abuse, which reduces your terror radius when you're not in a chase and increases it when you are, this would be very fun to put on to make it so that your bell and your terror radius are the same size to sneak up on unsuspecting survivors. In addition to these changes, the whoosh, indicating that he has actually gone into the invisible state, the cloak state, will be set to 56 meters. We might change this if it is too large, but at the moment, it seems like a comfortable range. You may reduce this using the add-ons that we're currently reducing the cloaking sound. Sorry, not the cloaking sound, but the bell sound. Those will be now affecting the whoosh range by 30 and 15%, and they stack.
I'm sorry to interrupt. It's an interesting question. Will you consider changing Plunderer's Instinct to show auras of all item on ground in addition to chests now that we have to deal with Franklin's demise?
Absolutely. And I also saw a suggestion, something that we've been talking about for a while, adding generator breaking speed to brutal strength.
Yes.
This is not coming. No, I'm just kidding. This is coming. This would be really fun to have as well. So we hear you. Please keep setting up
these
suggestions.
Ideas. Yes, please.
I'm nearly done. So
I want to see the thing.
Please. Yeah, I'm getting there. That's the best part.
Okay.
What's that? One of the things we wanted to do with the Wraith, and one of his best points or his key points, is that he should be a very strong hunter. In comparison to the majority of our killers, this is his strong point. This is his strength, as well as high movement speed to get around the map. His movement speed we're looking to buff while he's cloaked to perhaps Bloodlust level 2. When he is cloaked, we are looking, at first we wanted to explore changing his vision into a borrowed time mode, which is basically a black and white mode. And what we wanted to do was actually make the blood much more brighter, as well as the scratch marks and auras and loud noises to allow you to track survivors a lot easier. And it would actually help you track people while, after you've hit them once, you can re-cloak, follow their blood to find them again. Bjorn, would you mind showing what that looked like? Keep in mind, this is a work in progress. Oh yeah, this is the video, I guess it would be the first video, not the two. I apologize, Bjorn. I did not give you better instructions.
You did.
I didn't give him any instructions, actually. Bjorn flies by the seat of his pants.
Nah, he's okay.
So after you've cloaked, the world changes and comes back. Now this is a work in progress, as I've mentioned. The black and white mode, I don't believe, will be going into the game.
Mm, not like this, for sure.
No, but we're looking, because we wanted to specifically make the blood a lot more visible, as well as the scratch marks, and due to the way that our game is currently being processed, this is not going to be very achievable with the filter that we're currently using for borrowed time. This does not mean that all hope is lost. Actually, it just means that we have another direction and more hope.
Yeah.
So, we're going to be looking into actually increasing the brightness of the blood and the scratch marks to achieve a much more colorful
red. Well, the idea was to make sure that when you're cloaked, you cannot miss blood, you cannot miss scratch marks.
Exactly. Now, in addition to this, we are also adding something that was much demanded for. The generator break, pallet break while cloaked. This is the second video. Bjorn, if you wouldn't mind. Also going to be coming in with the Wraith. Whether he remains cloaked after breaking the generator or pallet is...
up for debate right now?
Up for debate. Pop. So I hope you enjoyed that. Please, you may write to me in general public. Meaning in like Reddit, Steam.
Yeah,
posts.
Not just like send a self-addressed.
You could, but I mean, I don't
stamped
know
envelope.
I don't know if I'd read it, because I don't know if I'd get it. I don't know where I am. So, you know, in the fog and the entity. So please, send me your feedback on this. I'd love to know what you guys think. And when it comes out, I hope you enjoy it.
Also, let us know if you like those little tidbits that are part of our process. Here, I just bit my tongue so
that
hard.
That happened?
Yeah.
Right. That sucks.
That's horrible.
Oh.
Anyway, but yeah, so showing you how we're working and what we're thinking of doing and trying to get your feedback early on so we can have a better idea of if you think you're going to like that. That's valuable to us, so yeah,
absolutely.
Speak up.
Mm-hmm.
Are you currently pleased with the Doctor in Dead by Daylight at the moment? As a survivor, I hate playing against the Doctor, and I feel like that should be the proper response.
I love playing as a doctor. I'm like, everyone's screaming, I know exactly where everybody is, I don't need to run empathy or bond. I'm like, alright, cool, I can deal with this. Oh, the doctor's coming, got a closet, so I jump in. It's all good.
No, he's in a good place, I think.
Yeah. Scary, though.
What about allowing Wraith to pick up survivors in the dying state while cloaked?
Ooh.
Well, the idea was that when you are cloaked and you want to do something, there are some actions that you wouldn't necessarily have to decloak. The decloaking would be part of doing the action. So you, it's shortening the delays.
Yeah,
in there.
Yeah.
That's the idea.
Yeah,
so
yeah, good possibility.
But I have a few questions here. The Q&A, actually, that I forgot. Were you done with this?
I was done with this.
Okay. Any chance we could reduce the brightness on killer blinds? I might be the only one, but after a few blinds, I start getting a decent headache.
Yeah, well, yeah, why not?
Yeah. I remember before you started that this game would have no story mode. There would be something for Dead by Daylight 2. Do you still plan to make a sequel in the future? So that's, there's two parts to this question. The first part is, yes, we did say there would be no story mode. We are telling a story, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
There is more of the story that's being unveiled as we release more content. But there will be no single player mode or campaign, really, in that sense.
To be fair, our players are telling a story.
But some people on the team, namely just, you know, me,
mm-hmm.
but are considering Dead by Daylight 2. I mean, at some point we might consider it, but right now nobody's spending any energy on that. Dead by Daylight is what it's all about. Can we make it so that Predator makes you see the aura of scratch marks instead of making them last longer? Lightweight would counter it by reducing the time they last. I'm not sure about the aura of scratch marks, but
I think it's totally possible. Actually, I found out
so
that it is possible, I believe, yesterday. So let's take a note. Let's take a little note down here, you know?
I'm guessing no mither counters the rate's brighter blood hunting.
You guessed right.
Well, it would be a good counter.
Of course.
Yeah.
That's the idea. That's what I wanted.
Why you delete a blue jacket from Meg at PS4? Okay, so that was a bug and it's in the next patch. I saw that. So the next update for PS4 will actually fix that. That's a bug. Where does the last survivor who was not hooked yet instantly die when he has at least, when he's the last one in the game? Would it be fair if she had at least a 3 chance to escape the hook?
I think the killer would hit you right away. I don't. He hooks you and then you die immediately, right?
So the last one dies immediately.
He could leave and then you'd have the 3 chances to escape. But I mean, why would he leave?
That's the thing. At that point, there's nothing else left for the killer to do.
Yeah,
yeah.
Unless the killer would like you to get off.
We've had these conversations in the past, especially at the beginning of the project, when we were wondering how much hope is still a little bit of hope before we call the game off and we say, no, it's not going to happen. And you're right, there is a little bit of hope. You could be put on the hook and manage to get off and run and make a break for it and jump into the hatch. It would be possible, but
with that hard as well?
Yeah, something.
Yeah.
But it's such a sliver of hope that we decided, yeah, let's wrap it up and start a new game. Yeah.
But I do believe there were some points about struggle. You can't struggle while you're on the hook, and since you automatically die, maybe you should just get the automatic struggle points as like the last survivor bonus.
It's a valid
good
point.
Idea. I don't see why not.
Obsession perks, more of them? Buff old obsession perks?
Yes. I had an idea for the Dying Light perk. Basically, right now, the way it works is that once your obsession is dead, everyone gets a repair debuff of 25%. Action speed debuff of 25%, which is quite a lot. But forces the killer to tunnel and forcibly hook and murder, if not camp, the survivor, which is not necessarily the
behavior we want to promote.
Yeah, at the moment. So what we're looking instead to do is potentially put, whenever the obsession is hooked, the bonus will then be applied to everybody else. And I think we can even leave the obsession infinitely on the hook, meaning that there is no drain, or the drain just takes very, very long. To allow for the killer to either have a strategy to stay and defend the area with the expense of the other players doing generators and just finishing the game, or going out and chasing survivors and trying to do a balance of protecting his prey, which is more of what the obsession perks are all about. Again, I'd love to hear your feedback, as this is a significant change to the perk, but I think it'd be really fun for everybody. So let
Absolutely.
Me know.
Can we run borrowed time and say we Kobe off the hook? Can we trigger our own borrowed time effect? Well, first of all, I'd like to say I think borrowed time is powerful enough as it is.
It is.
But also the intention of borrowed time, the idea behind, was altruism. It's someone helping someone else.
Yeah.
That's the essence of Bill, and that's what it was all about. Therefore, this would not fit at all within the...
Not really. You're doing it yourself at that point.
Yeah.
But we are looking into an invincibility frame for when you are jumping off the hook, so you can't get hit during that time period.
Yeah.
And you can only get hit once you have control of your character, and in theory could have done one button press, which could have been a dead hard, for example.
Can we add a new mechanic where survivors have to find a gear near fire barrels first and place it into a gen before they can start repairing the specific gen? This would counter gen rush and add an additional main objective. That's something that in some form or other has been discussed many times, finding parts for the gen, either to finish them or to start them, or
yeah,
different ways of it. It's not a bad idea. It's a good idea, but it has many, many implications in the delicate balance of the game.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it could be cool.
It could be possible, yeah, absolutely.
When playing killer, can we have an option to deny survival with friend? I mean, this keeps coming back.
It's horrible.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Are you nervous?
I am always nervous.
Yeah, you are a twitchy guy.
Yeah.
When playing killer, can we have an option to deny survival with friend? So what's your take on that? Everybody's got their opinions. Most of them are extremely strong opinions on that, but...
I'm the kind of player who likes to challenge myself a lot, so
yeah.
I actually
embrace like,
bring
it on.
Situations. Yeah, I'm the person who would like to teach other players my tactics, so then I can see them using my tactics and then beat myself, so that I can always be the best.
Yeah.
So I feel like these are situations that you can do this yourself. Now, with that being said, I do believe there's a significant mismatch that happens time and time again, because Survive with Friends is very difficult to manage. And I've seen this in a lot of different games. I've experienced it myself. There's even, like, I remember back in the day with World of Warcraft, you could have, like, one guy who was running, like, was it multi-boxing? So you can have, like, 15 shamans running
all
around.
All doing the same thing.
And they're all in a battleground, and I just see them, and I'm just like, I'm dead. And I'm like, all right, what the hell can I do with that? And you have to, like, send, you have to be all coordinated. It's impossible.
Yeah.
It's not cool, right?
So what we're talking mostly is adding maybe a... Hi!
Better balance. A better balance,
yeah.
Like a better matchmaking situation.
More points, like a point multiplier or something for facing Survive with Friends.
Or even like if you play Survive with Friends and the majority of your like group level is 10, let's say, maybe we make you play against a level 5 killer, something of that nature. There are things that we can do and we are looking into, but I don't think Survive with Friends would necessarily be removed.
Well,
with
no.
regards to saying to that as well, I believe that we can educate our player base, as well as our community, can educate the player base instead of yelling at each other through chat, helping each other out to realize the ways that we can play and improve on our processes and how our, the tactics that we're using, our strategies.
Absolutely.
So we can all become a better community and get better at the game. Therefore, our matches should be overall more balanced. Now, my last thing, if I may, just
sure.
This is my own thing.
This is your time.
The killers who are playing a game and seeing that it's too easy, you know, and you're playing and you're just slaughtering everybody.
Yeah.
You guys drive the experience of your survivors, right? And if you want the survivors to keep coming back to get murdered again,
make
play
it
with
fun.
Them. Play with them. Make it fun. If you're playing Myers, you know, put yourself in weird positions. See how the stalking can make them jump and see the character move when they realize you've been there. You know, these are the ways that we can help the overall health of our community.
I absolutely agree.
Yeah.
This is the game. It's a shortcoming of the game, but it's also one of its biggest strengths is the fact that the players create the narrative and create the experience for the other players.
Absolutely.
And the more we all try to make it better, the most amazing experience it's going to be.
It can be
everyone.
So much fun. I've played games where
because
I've
when it works.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
So good. I've played with Myers and like just stuck in tier one all game, just spooking people and then like running the other side of the map and all of a sudden appearing in front of them and smacking them and it's like, hey!
The other thing also
that.
Is that it's, I mean, for me when I play, oftentimes I want to try, I don't know, an add-on that I don't usually try or something like that and strategies or perks that I don't usually try and I have to sort of fight the urge to go, oh yeah, but I want to win, I want a sure thing, I want to make sure that I know what I'm doing. But it's still fun to try things. Like I was trying the hag add-on that I hate, doesn't matter. But I tried it, because I was always like, it's sort of, it scared me, but I'm not going to be sure. I'm probably going to lose the game. You know what? Big deal.
Yeah.
Still have a good time.
Absolutely. And just to
yes.
say, survivors as well, it's not just killers. I didn't get to that point. But I was saying that killers, you know, you have the ability to make the game more fun. Survivors as well. I mean,
absolutely.
Like if you see the guy has a really hard time chasing you, you know, I'm not necessarily saying let him hit you and let him beat you up. Right, but you can give him a nice
maybe
little chase.
Be a little bolder than you usually are.
Yeah, maybe not as much pallet looping and more like I'm gonna actually try to hide now, because
yeah.
you have the opportunity to find out strategies that might, you know, you might not have the opportunity to do so when you have a killer that is just monstrous bearing down on you, and you're just like, Jesus, every second counts. I need to make sure that I can, you know, get away or live a little longer.
Are you considering printing a physical copy of the art book? I did.
Oh,
I did print a copy of the art book, but
Ooh.
That's just me printing a copy of the art book.
That sounds like fun.
If you do have the digital copy of the art book, there are many websites out there where you can just sort of literally put the PDF in and print it out.
Cool.
Yeah, so it's possible to do that, and I recommend it. It's a gorgeous book. Can you add a different sound cue for killer notification? Example, a different sound for Trill the Hunt as opposed to failing a gen skill check.
Very possible. Actually, we have something. When did we do it? Oh yeah, we did it for the bear trap. So whenever someone gets stuck in a bear trap,
mm-hmm.
the loud noise is Dwight getting caught in a bear trap, which is amazing. We always use Dwight. I don't know if you know this. When you see you know, the madness screams and everyone's screaming, it's Dwight again. He's like, ah. Same. I guess it's the same kind of animation.
Yeah.
I guess for both. But anyways, we can do the same thing for the totems and in theory give you a loud noise with the totem inside of it
yeah.
for a throw of the hunt. And maybe give you another little noise notification sound. I don't know if it would be necessary to give you the unique sounds.
Yeah.
It could be good. Obviously, you'd be able to use this information, but it might also be too much for other players. So we'll see what we're going to do with it.
When are we getting more Survivor and Killers theme backgrounds? We actually talked about it this week. Right now, the people doing that are doing a shit ton of other stuff, and it seems to always fall back to the bottom of the pile, but it's something that we would like to be to do for sure. Why doesn't Deja Vu work?
Deja Vu? Oh, it does for 2 seconds.
Which is way too weak.
Yeah,
we all know that.
We're going to fix it.
Yeah.
We have different ideas.
Memcote, what do the killers do when they're not hunting survivors? Are they tolerant of each other's company? If so, which killers get along best with each other?
He should stick around for
the that's exactly that leads to from the web. There's going to be an answer to the first question. The other, are they tolerant of each other's company? Not really is the answer to that.
It's true.
And if so, which killers get along best with each other? I am not gonna answer that one.
You wouldn't be like the hag in like Leatherface?
Probably Leatherface and Hillbilly might get along, I guess.
About their chainsaws? Wouldn't they be indifferent?
Yeah. But the killers tend to not have a very active social life, I'd say, as a general rule.
Right, I guess. Doesn't help.
Yeah.
They work with gestures.
Maybe just like the Wraith and Michael Myers, and they just sit quietly in a room and stare at each other.
I could see that happening. I could totally see that happening.
And you know what they say? Friendship is being able to sit quietly with someone and not feel the weight of the silence.
Just the weight of their stare.
Yep, that's it.
Wonderful.
Will the Halloween event have triple or double Blood Point Weekend? I don't know. Could be quadruple. What do I know?
Quadruple? Jesus, you're going to give Thomas a heart attack.
Yeah. I didn't say that, Thomas. Okay. What are your opinions on being able to see trappers' traps too easily without add-ons?
If they are really easy to see, are you increasing your brightness? If the killers are placing them in the open, I guess it's the killer's fault.
I don't know. People still fall in my trap, so I guess they don't all see him.
Well, not a lot of people look at the ground. It's a difficult task while you're running.
Well, once you know you're against the trapper, you might start looking differently.
Yeah.
But
it doesn't mean that we're not going to look into it. There might be a possibility
of
making it lower. I don't know if it's too visible, though.
Yeah. Huh? Any update on the new website system for submitting tickets, blood point compensation for loss of progress? No, I don't have an update on the website system for the support system, unfortunately. When we do have an update, I will let you know. Is there more merch planned for the store? Yes, absolutely. And Comic-Con will show you some of them.
Cool.
So next week, we'll have something.
We have somebody in-house who helps design those, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Phil?
Yes, among other people.
No way.
All right, so I think we are up to my favorite part of the program, which is not true because I do enjoy doing this. But since Gabriel was not here to stop me today, I really went all out and I have a lot of really cool stuff to show that I found around the web. Oh, I had stats also. Very interesting stats that our friend Julien put together for me. I usually ask him during the week, hey, if you have a moment, can you find some interesting stats to show? And this is what he has for you people this week. That's not it at all. Oh, is that the one I gave you? Oh, well, that's horrible. So close that. I don't have the stats with me right now. I could give them to you, but that's not the right one. Well, that's weird. Sorry about that, people. We're usually very good at this. Okay, give me a second. Okay, I'll try to find it. Can you send me the link to where I dropped this, and I will... Oh, yeah, I did not give you the right one. Okay, so in the meantime, we will go and look at the cool stuff that we found on the web. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you, Bjorn. First, we start with this. I think that a lot of people are quite excited with our friend the Huntress. That's a good version of it. I like how thick she is. That's Hovering About that did this. Thank you very much. Next one is I Am Violet. That's awesome.
That is so cool.
Yeah, that's really, really cool.
But Bill.
Oh, you missed one. It doesn't matter. You're going to bring it later? That's fine.
He's going to bring it back.
No, you're going to show it right now? Oh, that was before that.
It was two. Oh, no, it's three.
Yeah, that's the one. That's from Dr. Strog, who did the cosplay of the hillbilly that showed.
That is awesome.
He created a whole sequence of all the different killers. Go check them out. But for now, I wanted to show this one.
He almost looks like a Bane version of Trapper.
Yeah, absolutely. Why is this not working? Ah, there we go. So I put that PowerPoint in there for later. Okay, the next one we have here is from Kuno. That's a beautiful nurse there. A little thin, but it's an interesting version. The next one is from Kuros B.
That's
seriously
cool.
I think that was Sailor Moon can go back to her home on I don't know where she lives. Lena Cries created this very soft and gentle version. I'm not sure what's happening there.
A lot of Anna.
Yeah. Then we have a Mafia Cat, because can't have a day without Nia. Thank you very much. Meticulous Hand answers the question. This is what killers do when they are not required for a trial.
So you're saying that Myers is behind the door?
Well, I'm not sure, but and I'm not sure. Maybe he's on the body pillow. Wraith has a Myers body pillow.
That's amazing.
Then Nezvestny made this, which is quite amusing. The next one is from Not the Basement. Always.
Wonderful.
Spot on. Then Pericote did this two-parter that I really like. Pericote, I'll say Pericote. The next one is the second part of this, which I don't know how more adorable you can go. Then we have Respawn Bunny. As we were saying,
so cool.
We absolutely both want to play that 8-bit game. Then Shell. I love the, the art style. I want to read that comic. Then Snowy. Much more classic take on it. Very nice. Wayland made this. I'm not sure exactly what's happening there, but some people think that the Doctor is a model. So Bug Brea Chart finished the lineup with this amazing piece of art. We all need a hobby.
Yes.
An outlet. So there, that was the extent of what I found around the web. I'm very happy with my findings this week. Now we can go back to the palettes presentation. There we go. DIY Palettes Project Edition. So thank you, Julien, for that. Very interesting. Average survivors drop 2.1 palettes per match. 67% of survivors who dropped 3+ palettes failed to stun the killer.
That makes sense then.
Rank 20s obviously have a much lower rate of success with the pallet drops to stun. Rank 1 stun about 1 out of 3,
Damn.
Which is not bad, because they are facing rank 1 killers most of the time.
Mm-hmm.
PC players have a slightly better average of stun success than Xbox or PS4s, which are similar. And then on average, the group of survivors, they drop 50% of all the pallets on the map and only 0.2% of the games end with all pallets on the map being used.
That's insane.
Which is very, very small. There's always one left somewhere.
Yep. So that last photo about the Doctor being buffed.
Yeah.
Are we going to see the Wraith with like
I really
big
hope.
Legs? I really feel like he'd finally go to leg day, and that's where he got his buffs from.
That would be okay. Let's see what we can do with that.
I think
that would alternate outfit.
Yeah,
give leg day.
Thunder thighs. I want to see it. I want to bring it down. Let's do this.
Okay. Let's let's put that in the maybe pile.
He's lifting his bell.
Yeah. Dumbbells. Yes. So, that's all I had for today. I feel like that was quite a lot anyway.
That was a good one.
If you have any more questions, this is the last moment to screen them. Oh, can we stop? No. No. Killer Swimsuit Pack when? McLean, go back to work. It's ridiculous.
At least he didn't ask in the chat, right? Or did he?
Probably.
You? No, I'm just kidding. Wait, so when are we going to get that?
Do you think you will ever add Benedict Baker?
That'd be so cool. Where did he go?
Maybe.
What
Maybe.
Happened to him?
Well, that's...
Is he okay?
I'd be the only one that is.
Really?
Well.
I want to
I don't know.
Mark.
Yeah, I want to know. I want to play Benedict in his wheelchair.
His wheelchair?
I don't know. No, I don't think so.
Does it have like flashlights attached to the front?
Yeah, probably.
That'd be so cool.
Yeah.
I'd be down.
Okay. Well, that's it. If you don't have any more questions, then we'll leave it at that for now and go back to play. I think you will be able to enjoy the patch that's coming out any minute now.
Imminently.
And that's it. So thank you very much, Bjorn, for helping us again today.
Thank you
to all of our mods who helped keep this moderately civil. Can we compile all the from the web and put it together for everyone to download? That would be nice. Dick Fort, I hope you will be okay. Take a deep breath and check pictures of me. I guess that'll help. Then the news I will repeat before we leave. So the news, Leatherface is coming out for PS4 next Tuesday. It's already out on Xbox One. We will be at New York Comic Con next week. Come see us, shake our hands, and show us your most awesome cosplay from Dead by Daylight. I mean, even the other cosplays were interested, but yeah, it'll be fun.
Bring it on.
Loss of progress. We are testing right now with a small segment of the population. We'll open the doors quickly to make sure that it works, and then we'll patch it for everyone. And the big bug of hooks getting stuck in it is being fixed as we speak.
Cool. One last thing.
Yes?
Yeah, I've been screaming about Survivor stuff. They're asking what Survivor buffs are coming. I am working on that. So we're looking at scoring and a bunch of stuff. We have the... when are we doing the talk about the new...
So when we are
thing, the
ready thing. To release the big update with the rewards in the end, the victory, the equivalent of the victory cube for survivors, when we're getting really close to releasing it, we'll sit down, we'll probably invite Thomas, who was a big part of that, maybe McLean, who did a lot of the programming on this, and we'll go through the details of that. But we won't do it until we're very close to patching it.
Cool.
Because then people will forget about it anyway if it's 3 weeks later.
That's fair. But we are looking into these things, and these are things that will be coming. It won't be just killer bugs that you'll be seeing. It should be for everybody.
It'll change everybody's life.
But ideally, yes. That's how we should be looking at this, how we should be perceiving this. If there is a killer adjustment, it means that there's an adjustment to Dead by Daylight for how it's going to play for everyone.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily targeting one side over the other side. It's trying to get a healthy environment so everyone can have fun.
There you go.
So we're not necessarily trying to make it more power to the killers versus more power to the survivors.
We want better games.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, we're going to keep trying to achieve this. Let us know what your opinions are and how we can achieve it. We'll be attentive.
Yes. That's it, buddy. So thank you for joining us again this week, and we'll see you next time.
Absolutely. Have a great one.
Bye.